Hi guys, this is Simon with Trade and Perform Coaching, doing the trade review for Monday, the 19th of May. So this morning when we were coming in, obviously something that I hammer every single day is my concern for the open drives higher, okay? And that's exactly what we got when we got this move up right in here. See these first three bars? You should print them, circle them. That is open drive higher. Now, the only thing that open drive higher was missing that didn't give it the force that normally open drives higher will often have accompanying them was either a significant gap down where we got a huge negative tick. That didn't happen. And we didn't get a gap up out of range, right? We were actually opening right below the bottom of resistance. And in the morning I had mentioned, if you'll look on this volume profile here, that pull it up. I had mentioned that this area right here, the 7850, really 7850 specifically, but right up into this 82 area, right, was key. We'd obviously gapped up here last time, and this is what, if you go back and look at this trade date on the 12th, you'll see what a gap up and an open drive higher, when it truly has force, when it gaps out of range, how big a move it can make. But what we ended up doing was we opened right in range. We came back for a little bit of a backside test and re-auctioned this poorly auctioned area here, and then we drove higher from there. So where I was looking to get long on this particular trade was back here in this white zone right down here. Let me erase. Okay, so this is the area, I'll mark it right here. This is the area I wanted to be long in. Okay, and so remember, how do I handle when I approach the market? What am I looking to do? Okay, so there's two approaches to the market. You can try to capture as many profitable trades through the course of the day, right, and make a lot of money that way. That usually doesn't work. Most people fail at that attempt. Or the other way to do it is to go, look, I know where my highest odds are. I know where I have to get the market stretched, okay, and I have the best odds of catching someone else off guard, or making a trading error. And for me this morning, that was in the white zone. It just didn't get there. I don't cry over spilt milk. It didn't give me the opportunity, and it didn't cost me anything either. I'm fine. I promise you, there's very few people who just bought in the middle of space here if they did this every single day and bought where there simply was no, absolutely no structure or very little structure, at least in my opinion, that there's very few people who would have been successful. Most days we're going to get a test of Globex low, especially on a down opening when we're not gapping out of range or gapping above the prior day's gap, right? Or quite often what we'll do is we'll have a pattern that follows up in the gap, and then we come back down and test Globex low. So I knew where I wanted to get long. The second part of that formula was, if I couldn't get long, right, where did I want to get short becomes the question. And I can answer that question. I said the first time into this Friday's high / Globex high that I wanted to get short in that area. And the other caveat that I put out there was that if I did get short in this area, and I'm talking about this area right in here, okay, if I did get short right in here, that I wanted it to get below and close below relatively quickly this location right here. Why? I needed to get underneath that gap. I needed to get underneath Friday's high to get a push back to the downside. Okay, so the next question that's logical, what are the things that keep me safe once I take a short? First thing I had greater than a 5-6 point rotation into that area. That helped tremendously, right? 1870, 1869.50 was a low. I took my short at 1876.50, utilizing that 6 point rotation to give me trade location. That put me in approximately right here. Okay, next thing, I have a timer. If it takes more than 25 minutes for me to attain my target, I move my stops down from 2 points behind the zone to whatever the swing high is, or I can close the trade. That's my next choice. That's my next choice in terms of managing that trade, right? And then, of course, if I'm able to attain my 2 points, right, and where I'm looking to get that 2 points is right here, right? If I shorted 76.5, 74.50, right a tick below this gap, this is my bogey. And you'll notice 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 minutes. At 25 minutes, I was able to get my 2 points. At this point, you had to make a simple decision, right? Were you going to move your stop to net break even, where if the trade moved against you, you lost nothing? Or are you going to move it to true break even, where if it comes back against you, you can simply close out the balance? Now, remember, my entire trading methodology at its most simplest form simply says I'm going to take 2 points on every trade and close out and wait for my next opportunity. What does that require in order to win? Well, generally, it requires that you have a 70% win rate. Below 70%, the inverted risk reward kind of gets a little screwy there. But I can tell you, for a long, long time, day in, day out, I've been maintaining these high win rates. Some months are tougher than others. Some months it doesn't produce as nice a profit as others, right? But I can tell you, generally speaking, it has given me consistent winning days, weeks, and months. And to back that up even further, right, where was the next trade location that I pointed out in the morning? It was right up here at 1881. There was a zone at 1879 to 1881. All of this, because of where Globex High came in, it was prudent to eliminate the 1879 area. And even though the first hour high fell right in that, right, we came within a tick of that 1879 before rejecting again. But what was prudent to get the best trade location next? Well, treating this like it was the back of a zone with a 2-point stop behind, the first time we got to 1881, that gave us a push down, right, from eventually what was 1882, only 1 point of heat, right, all the way down to 1878.50, easily acquiring the 2 points. Now think about that. The target is to get two high odds trades for 2 points a day, right? The fact that I'm capable of doing more than that is great, but that's all I need at my most basic to build a large trading account. Do the math. Assume a loss, okay? Assume a loss in there every couple of trades. And so let's say you come up with an average of 3 points, or right, per day, averaging in a 1 point, 1 point going to be a loser over a spread of trades, right? That's 15 points a week. That comes out to 60 points a month. Now, that's theoretical. I'm not saying it works out that like that every month. Sometimes it works out far better. Sometimes it works a little bit less, right? But the point is that is if you know you've got great trade location, which I know I do, and you know you have a high odds of winning, right, and you know you have the ability to control your downside risk, you don't need a whole lot more than that. Not only that, but check this out. People who had to chase this today, the majority of people, if you know yourself or you know other traders, right, the majority of guys did not buy down here. Majority of guys chased up. They said, oh, trend day up, I'm going to buy here. What do most retail traders use for a stop? Most of them use a point, point and a half, maybe 2 points. Those people that chased into here, right, from here up, right, all the way through here, thinking, ooh, I've got a high of the day, they ended up with a 2-point loss. Now, guess what? They may have jumped back in, right? Maybe they jumped back in here when we broke a new high. Look how long these people waited without being able to get out for profit. Not only that, okay, so this is already from 10 o'clock till 1 o'clock till we broke new highs again, and even after that, a pullback down afterwards, right? Why? Because at this point, we're in balance, and breakouts get sold, and breakdowns get bought. That's what happens when we're in balance, and we get moved into balance with an upward bias, okay? The last piece in this is that people who chased, even if they made money on days like today, the majority of the days, go look at the behavior of the market. Most days the market does not function in this kind of fashion. Okay, most days it functions in this type of fashion. Here, let's erase this so everyone's clear. Most days it goes like this. Okay, where it makes very little to no progress. It may, you know, it might close up 20 points from where the low was. It might close down 10 points from where the high was. But very few days in ES do we go like this. Okay, which means people who chase in ES tend to lose money. Okay, and there's two factors that you have to take into consideration. Okay, first of all, what is your plan for long-term survival? Secondly, where is it the hardest for someone else to take money from you, and the easiest for you to take money from someone else? Well, let me answer that question, okay? Because this I do know for a fact. The easiest place to take money from someone else is when the market is nice and stretched, like it is here, okay? and you nail them. When it's nice and stretched into a key location and you nail them, okay? The hardest way to make money in this market is both from a psychological standpoint is when you chase and you buy up at highs and you have to survive these pull downs, not knowing if it's going to be a 3-point pull down, a 5-point pull down, or a 10-point pull down, right? Even this guy who called it right, let's say you were a trader who called it right, but you had a 2-point stop. And he said, okay, well, they head faked me once, but I'm going to get it again. And I'm going to take my long on a new breakout again, right? This is the chaser, right? He's already down 2 over here, minimum, right? And then he gets chased in again, 1878.50. Well, he needs all the way up to 1880.50 just to get break even. At this point, the guy has made $50, and that's if he nailed the exit at the high, okay? You put in his commissions, he spent, if he only did 2 trades, right? And we know our hero here probably hasn't, okay? That means he's only at 40 points on the day for taking an enormous amount of risk and using a 1.5 to 2-point stop. So he's risked $200 to make $40. How does that make any sense in terms of trying to make a consistent profit, right? Had we gotten the rotation this morning and you were a smart trader, okay, and you were simply playing the cat waiting for the bird to land right in front of you, okay, I don't even know if that makes sense, but I'm so tired it doesn't matter at this point, okay? You were sitting right here for backside test of this trend line, right, and you were just waiting to get paid. I also mentioned prior to the open, right, if we couldn't break this trend line to the downside, there was not much downside to be had, and that we would be lucky to get a test here into this location for long. But other than that, the buyers were in control. So even on a day when buyers, so the takeaway here, the stretches that were offered for a good location were to the upside, forcing me to play the short side of the trade or not participate at all. The best locations were on stretches at particular support resistance levels, which were highlighted before the market, right? And they each paid me 2 points apiece for 4 points total, right? And that's on the most basic of strategies, okay? I guess that's really my message here. So that's all you need is 1 or 2 trades a day to build a huge trading account. And I want to leave everyone with that thought. You don't have to capture everything. Do the math. If you can have a consistently high win rate and you can increase your trade size over time, the sky's the limit for your trading account. And I would encourage you to strongly examine it. If you have questions about it or you challenge even the hypothesis, I'm open to those ideas, right? Because I believe I can respond over time in a day-by-day fashion and show you that, no, it actually is possible to stay consistently profitable and make a lot of money trading, right? It's not necessarily glamorous, but it is possible, and it's highly rewarding. When you shift your focus as a trader from how much money I can make to how can I dominate the process of what the market goes through and how can I be the one to be the sniper, to pick off the bull or the bear when they make the mistake, right, and put that bullet right between its eyes and take its money right out of its pocket, right? That is a highly satisfying feeling, okay, to know that you've become the master over other people's incompetence in trading. That is a huge win for you. And so, at any rate, my name is Simon. I've really been encouraged by the results I've seen from the guys I've been coaching. I've accomplished far more than I thought I was going to be able to with the traders I've worked with. And I'm really, really proud of you guys if y'all are listening. I'm really proud of the job y'all have done of taking yourselves from being frustrated, break even, or losing traders to, you know, either from losing to break even and about to go to profitability, or for the majority of y'all, y'all have gone to consistent profitability. And I can't tell you it's the most rewarding thing I've done in my career outside of make a lot of money for myself, but it's the best thing I've done for others. And so I truly appreciate it. And there's really, as I'm getting older, I'm seeing that one of the best rewards is giving back to others and helping others accomplish for themselves after so many years of taking out of the market for myself. So anyways, my name is Simon. I'm with Trade and Perform Coaching. You can reach me at tradeandperform@gmail.com. The morning trade reviews have gone private. As soon as I get everything ironed out, I might start offering a trial subscription. I haven't worked out the details on that. It's only $95 a month. That's less than 2 ES points a month. And if you're not making that with the way I'm guiding you, there's a problem anyways, and you probably shouldn't be in the room, right? Because it's a very simple approach to trading the market. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I want to say. If you have any questions, email me. I'm tired. I'm going to go to bed, post this, and I will see you all bright and early in the morning. It's almost midnight here. So Talk to you later, guys. Good night.